Hi there, my name is Chelsea. Welcome to Little Mountain Ranch. Today we are going to be going out and spending a whole bunch of time in the garden, and I thought I would bring you along with us. We have a whole bunch of different things to do, just getting things cleaned up. The temperatures have shifted dramatically here in the last couple of days, which is really great because the forest fires have been absolutely out of control, and it's only 15 degrees Celsius outside right now. And you can feel autumn in the air. This is pretty typical for us for the mid of August. Last year we even had frost at this time, but thankfully I think we're gonna have warmer temperatures at least for the next few weeks so that my squash can develop and all of my tomatoes can ripen on the vine, hopefully. Without further ado, let's get down to the garden and I'll show you, whoa, a little windy all of a sudden, and I'll show you what we're up to. Do you guys want to show everybody the bunnies?
Yeah.
Gonna bring them over? Before we head down to the garden, the kids just want to show you their bunnies. They're raising lionhead rabbits. Come on up here. You stand up here, maybe they'll be able to see. Look at that cutie. So these are lionhead rabbits, and they're just about ready to go to their new homes, aren't they? But we do have a little bit of an issue, and that is that this guy, who's down here, Cypress, likes to eat bunnies. He's absolutely fantastic with all of the rest of our livestock here on the property, but rabbits just trigger his hunting instinct and he just can't help himself. Cypress. So we have to be very, very careful with the bunnies and the dogs. Maple, you're pretty good though, aren't ya? Okay guys, you wanna go put the bunnies away and we'll head down to the garden? Come on guys. Let's go, out you come. Okay, there you go, guys. Before we head down to the main garden, I'll show you how my squash patch is looking. Let's see what we have in here. These gorgeous guys here, these are baby blue Hubbard squash and they're looking really good. There's several on each vine. This is a Jack Be Nimble, I think is what it's called. Little tiny pumpkin down there. These ones are butternut squashes and they're looking okay size-wise, not too bad. I do ripen a lot of my squash in the house every year. Last year I didn't have to, which was the first year, and I was kind of hoping the same for this year. Just because it's been so hot, I was hoping a lot of the squash would ripen on the vine. I wonder if we can get in over there to that giant pumpkin. Everything is still looking good and there is no sign a frost on the tips of the leaves here. One of the reasons I chose to grow my squash up here is because down in the garden, down by the hay field, is where we get frost first and we get frost last up here. So I was hoping that that strategy would work to give me at least another week for the squash. These are one of my favorite pumpkins down here. This is a Cinderella pumpkin and it is looking fantastic. These are a great pie pumpkin and they store really well. Hey Claire, can you grab the sprinkler over there and move it on this side? Because this is super dry over here. Can you see these gigantic Geet Oak Kasamon squash in there? I can't remember the name of this pumpkin, but these are looking absolutely gorgeous. That dog and that dog are not supposed to be in the squash patch. You guys, get out of my squash patch. Can you see that gigantic pumpkin? That's a Dill's Atlantic giant pumpkin. And it is huge. I'm so excited about that. Another Geet Oak Kasamon in behind there. And these here are my pickling cucumbers and we've been harvesting and making tons of pickles from this little row of pickles. They have done really well. Normally I keep them covered, but I haven't had to this year because of all of the heat. So hoping to get at least one more harvest off of these. I planted squash up on the upper part of this garden and then down below is potatoes and they are just about ready to harvest. So I'm probably gonna dig a few up today and see where we're at. One of the things that I do know just by digging up a few throughout the summer is that I do have some scab issues on some of the potato varieties, which kind of sucks. And we also had quite a lot of drought this summer and potatoes don't really do well in drought conditions. So, at least not in my experience. Last year we had somewhere around 2,000 pounds of potatoes we ended up harvesting, which was enough for us for an entire year. Plus we gave the pigs a bunch of them as well. And I don't think this is gonna be that kind of year, but I hope we get enough to at least last us out the winter. But I'll keep you guys updated on that. So let's head down to the main garden. my boo. I've been doing quite a bit of research into cabbage moths and how to combat them and deal with them. Like I said, I haven't had an issue in the past with them, so I haven't really had to do anything. But one of the things that I learned is that they overwinter under any plant matter that you leave in the garden. So my goal this year is to remove all of it, to get it all out, and to get it out early right now. Normally what I would do is leave all of the broccoli plants in the garden to flower for the bees. But this year, because it's been such a huge problem, I've just decided to rip them all out, and this is gonna go for to the pigs and to the chickens and the meat birds and all of that. Because Matt or Diego was there. The kids are just pulling the wagons and the wheelbarrow up to the pigs, and they'll be dumping those in with the pigs. All right, so we're gonna get to it now and hustle and get all of these pulled out. I don't think it's gonna take us more than half an hour to do that. And then we'll head down to the high tunnel and pick all of the ripe tomatoes. We also have a bunch of yellow beans to pick, which have done amazingly well this year with all the heat. All right, Boo, are you ready to help? No? If you see any side shoots, make sure you pull those off, okay? So we can use those for supper. Yeah, definitely. Any of the weeds too, for sure. This Everest broccoli is so fantastic for side shoots. Are those good? Okay, I'll just stick these in a pile here and we'll grab them on our way up. Because there are lots and lots of gorgeous side shoots on here. Yeah. Oh, ground cherries. Oh, they are. That's exciting. Do you guys want to try ground cherries?
Sure.
Hang on, I'm just going to show these guys first. This is my first year growing ground cherries. I'll show you the plant in a second, but you eat the fruit when they fall off onto the ground, and these guys haven't tried one before, so try one.
Kind of look
do you want to try one?
Tomatillos, mom.
Kind of like tomatillos. They're probably related. Did you want to try one, Kate?
No, thank you. No.
So it turns out I'm not a huge fan of the ground cherry. What do you guys think?
It's
no?
Good.
You like it? Here. But you like them. Oliver might have another one.
Ellie, how many do you have?
So I guess I won't be growing ground cherry again. Yep, open it up and try it and see what you think.
I want to.
You want to do it?
There. Look at it.
Pull it off. Ooh. I didn't like it. Sequoia really liked it though. Maybe you'll like it too.
Ground cherry.
Yeah, it's called a ground cherry. It's like a sweet tomato. Definitely not a fan. Oh, no, definitely not a fan. I just want to show you this over here. Fiona, what do you think? Is that yummy?
And she got her head stuck in there.
This is Ruby, and this is Fiona. And Fiona is almost 10 years old. She looks pretty good for an old girl. Let's try to make them in piles, guys, instead of just throwing them like out on the sides.
I told you.
Yeah. We are gonna head over and pick all of our yellow beans and our tomatoes.
Help.
No, that's all right. He's got it. I think this is going to be it for the yellow beans because there's no more flowers. So we can bring the ducks. Yeah, there's a couple, but we can bring the ducks in here and let them go nuts.
I think there's two girls.
Two boys? That's what it looked like to me, too.
Yeah, it looked like half and half.
And then maybe they can take care of the rest of the cabbage worms. I've heard they can be good for that.
Mom, when can we go to the big lake again?
Which big lake? Oh, like the lake at the top of the property? Maybe when Dad's off. We could hike up there. Sam's gonna come out on Sunday, so maybe we could all do it together. Because it was so hot.
It's a nice day.
It's beautiful. It's so nice. If you guys want, since these ones are done, you can actually pull the plant out and then just pull the beans off.
They're all over here. Where do you want them?
Just in the aisle.
Not till we're done.
No.
Nope. Yeah. We have to finish first. Pleasure comes after work. It feels so strange that it's fall already.
It does not feel strange. I love it.
Yeah, I know. But you're an autumn girl.
I am.
I love me some summer. Oh, I could do those for supper because I'm going to do pizza for dinner tonight. So I could do some pizza and onion rings.
That's kind of a weird combination.
What's up? Onion rings?
I don't know. I kind of feel like it's finger food. They're both finger food.
Look how many I've done so far on my own.
Nice.
Never.
We only have one more thing to do, and that's just pick tomatoes, and that's easy.
Can we have tomato soup for lunch?
Oh, yum. With the fresh bread?
Yeah. Tomato soup.
That sounds amazing.
Yes.
Let's do it. Mm-hmm. It's super windy, and the back of the high tunnel just blew off again. This happened the other day as well. And that's not something that happened at all last year, did it? The back didn't? No, it didn't. Okay, guys, let's pick all the tomatoes and see how many we can get.
Are we going to put all kinds of tomatoes in?
Yes.
So it has all kinds of flavors.
We'll make it like a multi.
I'm going to take off the ends.
Oh, good idea. That saves us time, doesn't it? Mm-hmm. We're going to have tomato soup for lunch. Diego's quite excited about it. So am I. Yeah, you need to help too.
Do we just pick the red tomatoes?
All of the tomatoes that are ripe, including the cherry tomatoes, like all the orange ones. Because they make really nice
soup.
Because they're so acidic.
Tomato soup?
Yes, they are.
Yeet. I'm not a big fan of these ones, Mom.
I won't be planting again. Those are those amethyst cream.
Can I try one, Mom?
Not. Yep, you can try one.
I wouldn't have done that if I were you.
You know which ones I didn't plant that I wanted to plant was the German, old German. Those ones were so good last year. When I, was not.
Do you want help trying to pick on those?
Sure. I forgot to mention this one. This one's called Prairie Pride. In my last video where I was talking about tomatoes. And this is a determinant bush style tomato. And I am definitely going to be growing these ones again because this is a really nice sized tomato for a northern garden. And they can up nicely. So are we just about done, everybody?
Yes.
Okay. All right, we have everything up in the house. We are going to make tomato soup, and I made the kids some ice cream as a reward for all their help. So that's exciting. All right, everyone, that is it for me today. I hope you all have a fantastic rest of your day, and I'll see you again next time. Bye.
Mom.
Yes, honey.
Can I, like,